Hi guys, welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to do keyword research for content writing. I know most of you have been struggling to rank your website in Google first page, or maybe trying to rank your content. In this video, I'm going to show you the simplest hack nobody have ever showed you on YouTube on how to do keyword research for content writing, because I know most people have been writing content but they're not seeing it in the Google first page. But after watching this video, implementing exactly what I'm going to teach you, you are going to be seeing your blog, your content on Google first page without stress. So let me show you how to do that. Now, all you have to do for me in return is to make sure you subscribe if you have not subscribed to this channel. Turn the notification bell once update anything concerning SEO, make money online, or any digital content, you'll get notifications. So let's do it right away. Okay, to do keyword research for content writing is very simple. If you have a new website that have low DA, there is a kind of a technique you need to apply in terms of doing keyword research. So you start seeing yourself in Google first page, fetching some little traffic before you can forge ahead in developing more content. So let's do it right now. I'm going to go to SEMrush. I'm using SEMrush. You can use Ahrefs, you can use Moz, you can use any keyword researching tools Obach suggests. But in this video, I'm using SEMrush. It's very simple. Now I'm going to go to keyword overview. From the right left hand side, once I choose keyword overview, what are your primary keyword? Your primary keyword, for example, crypto is primary keyword, finance is primary keyword, make money online is primary keyword, movie loan, these are primary keyword, investment, these are primary keyword. What is your primary keyword? You need to know your primary keyword before you start a niche, and that's when you pick a niche. If you know your primary keyword, that is easy for you to pick a niche, a topic to talk to, or maybe a topic to write about. That's the main important thing. So in this video, I'm using make money online as a primary keyword, because this is a primary keyword. Make money online is a primary keyword. Then choose the country you are targeting. We all know that Taiwan traffic is very, very expensive. Like if you have Google Ads on your website, you're going to Embero or affiliate marketing or anything related to selling products or generating lead, Taiwan country, which is the top country, is going to convert more than other countries like African country. So I'm going to hit search, and once I hit search, this is very, very simple. This is where the magic need to come, where we have to filter to go for long tail keyword. Make money online is short tail keyword, but how to make money online is long tail keyword. Again, example of short tail keyword, loan is short tail keyword. It's difficult. You can't rank loan. You can't explain about loan and rank. The easiest way is how to apply a loan in USA. Is easy. Is long tail. Long tail keywords are those keywords that is very hard, long, that targets long tail. Is just long. For example, how to make money online, that's just it. So what we're going to do in return, yes, if you see the volume and the difficulty is 100, which is the primary keyword, what we need to do is to scroll down so we can filter some useful keyword we can go for as a new website, or maybe a website that is struggling to rank, to get traffic, to get lead. So exactly, so let's see what we're going to do. We're going to click our view or keywords. We have over 24,000 keywords within the primary keyword. Each primary keywords have their own searching intents, like what people are searching within the loan, what people are searching within making money, what people are searching within crypto. So there are some kind of keywords that is within those primary keywords. So total number of the keyword under make money online is 24,000 something. So what we're going to do right now is to filter some keyword, the useful keyword that is very easy for us to rank. So let's do it right now. We're going to first of all focus on the KD. The KD means the keyword difficult. So if you're a new website, you have to go for easy ranking keywords and very easy ranking keywords. Okay, now it does not mean that you cannot rank in difficult and possible. If you can prove a nice content, look at what this SEMrush is saying before we forge ahead. Let's list them first. For you to go for keyword within the average 30 difficulty to 49 difficulty, you need a well-structured and unique content. Well-structured and unique content require time and money. So you need to prove a lot of content strategy. You need to prove a lot of points. If you are writing how to make money, you have to write more than the competitors what exactly are, right? Then you improve it more better, bring up new strategy, working strategy that is going to help the content to look well structured and unique. But most times new website owners don't really have much money to spend in content, so it's advisable you go for the easy one that you can easily rank. So we move down to easy. So let's choose easy as KD. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is also pick intent. Searching intent is what most people don't really know, and you can take out your time, go to your browser right now and type what is searching intent. You can be able to find the definition of searching intent. But before that, let me also explain to you what searching intent is. First of all, let's click here. Once we click here, you're going to see informational. Most times our content, we don't really know the right thing we are doing. Most of you target content based on, you write content that meant for questions, just for content. Like, for example, you don't really know what your content sound like, okay? What your content sound like. So for example, if you are to use informational in intent, which means the user want to find an answer to a specific question. Let's say, for example, how to make money online. How can I make money? This is the way to make money. This is the way to make money. You do this and do that, you start making money online. That's informational. So we need users that need information about making money online. Number one, that's the searching intent. Navigational. And navigational is, for example, if you choose navigational, then you are targeting users that want to find a specific page or website. Maybe seven top websites where you can be able to sign up and start making money. That's just it. Your audience is that one. But if you choose commercial, which is commercial, means the user wants to investigate a brand, which is review. How review about Semrush, review about the best SEO tools in 2022. These are just like you're trying to be commercial, like you're targeting people who are looking for review, or you're targeting people who want to know more about a particular brand before they invest their money. But transactional, most times, what's transactional means the user want to complete an action for conversion. Let's say, for example, you're writing how to make money online. You have, for example, an ebook you want to market. So you should target transactional as a new website owner so you can be able to fetch money and start building more quality content. So since we have our website without even having much money, but we want to generate income, so we should target informational and transactional, so which is going to convert to a lead or to submit email to grab some gift, then you can have their email and start using them to make money. Okay, first of all, since we have picked the intent, if you have for example, you have a web AdSense on your website, it's also advisable to pick your CPC. But for me, I don't think I need a CPC of a thing for now. I just want to focus on easy ranking keywords that I can easily rank as a new website owner and then explore to get more audience down to my website and get some lead and people who are needing information, so I can drive them to one of my monetized channels, like another way of monetization. But if you have Google AdSense, it's advisable to pick a CPC for yourself. So the next thing we're going to do, since we have choose the KD, the intent, what we need exactly is to export these keywords, these easy ones here. I think I'm going to go for, at least go for most of this content. These are just it. Make money online within strategy or whatever. These are just the keywords here. You can easily rank for. These are keywords and their volume is within average. Okay, let me check it out. Okay, yeah. So pick these ones. Pick within the average number you want, which is very easy for everybody to do that. Okay, so just pick the keywords, do some little research to find exactly what your audience are writing. I've already do a live video which I showed you guys how to structure your content, which you just pick a keyword, place it on Google search, check other competitors that is writing on it, see how they structure their own content and go more better than what they have already offered to Google. So you can still be more used to the keyword. I can easily pick possible if you really have money to spend in terms of writing content. There are some content that required more money. You need to spend money to get exactly what you want. So in most case, it's advisable to leave it very easy or easy for a new website, so you can easily get what you want. Okay, I think this is the place I'm going to end this video for most of you. If you have any question concerning keyword research, what you need to set up, just leave a comment or you draw for me to help YouTube algorithm to push this video to more audience that is looking for a way to do keyword research for content writing. All you have to do for me is to comment content SEO, or you write for me on the comment section your problem. I'm going to reply as soon as possible. See you guys next in my video. Bye. Peace out.